Spoke to you both in the dressing room, you both know I expect. Keep it clean, break straight away when told, and both of you watch the edge. Good luck to you both. Clear.
Touch gloves. Ladies and gentlemen, 12 three-minute rounds for the British Super Middleweight Championship.
All the talking is over. They raised the roof for the introductions. Just think what it's going to be like if Paul Smith wins it. Experience versus a mercurial emerging talent in James DeGale.
Well, the one thing both fighters are going to be up for this one. This means so much. It's coming early for DeGale.
Well, straight away, words from Howard Foster, the referee for James DeGale. Gave him his final instructions. Didn't take very long for him to step outside. Smith, such a tough man, only suffered one defeat in his professional career. That was against a southpaw in Steve Bendel, but it was a while back. He's come through two really hard fights in the last 14 months or so. Tony Dodson, and also against Quigley, defences of that title, a British title, and he had to dig deep in both of them. But he is a proud champion, and James DeGale, this is going to be a real searching examination of his credentials at, well, British title level, and certainly it'll give you a pointer if he wins as to whether or not he's going to be able to move on to higher levels than this.
Well, the tactics to Smith will make this grueling, to make DeGale box at a pace he's not used to. He's pretty new to the pro ranks, only 8 fights previous to this, so Smith really needs to make him feel what it's like to be in the pros. Forget the gold medals. This is about professional boxing.
Jim McDonnell told me that he thought that a key to this fight would be DeGale's ability to find the midriff of Paul Smith. He thought that body punches could be a key.
You'd think Smith has done all his work. This is a really meaningful fight for him. He knows he's got to win this.
Good shot, that one, from Paul Smith.
DeGale boxing out of the southpaw stance, that right hand carried very low. Smith will be looking to throw the right hand and bring the left hook behind it against the southpaw.
Smith said, if DeGale's daft enough to stand up and open up, then I'll get inspired and wipe him out of here early. The chants go up for Paul Smith. Interesting opening round, and you see the speed of DeGale there. But Smith getting in close and stifling his work. It's a good left hand, solid, fast left hand from DeGale.
Yep, the better work of the round at the end of the round from James DeGale.
Smith having to eat up a couple of solid shots in the last few seconds of the round, and a little bit of afters. Massive atmosphere here and a fascinating opening round. DeGale landing the cleaner shots, and over in Las Vegas, some very interested observers, David Hay, Adam Booth, and our commentator for the big fight coming up later on, Amir Khan against Marcus Maidana, that's Adam Smith. So second round of this British super middleweight title fight. DeGale do enough to take the opening, Glenn?
Yeah, I think he finished the round the better with some eye-catching punches, and that was his first round. tell already that the speed is with the Gael, is the power as well.
Smith believes he's the stronger man, though. And he has certainly talked with supreme confidence in the run-up to this, and saying tellingly, the later the fight goes, the more it favours me. Trying to work the body of De Gael. Smith, who was a star of the Contender Series, had a couple of fights on that much-hyped event. Newcastle and then over in the States.
Look it out, both of you. Come on, run it out. Some boxing.
And Howard Foster just wanting to tidy it up. Decent body shot from De Gael.
Just looking the classier of the two early in the fight, isn't he, De Gael?
Got a feeling that there is the possibility that Smith could mark up, could suffer from cuts. She has done in the past. Let's hope that's not going to be a factor. You want to see it being won on talent and being won as a boxing contest rather than something which is determined on facial injuries.
Noticeably standing out in range, Smith. Just being a little careful about committing himself.
Took the left hand, but I think he covered up and deflected most of the weight of that thrown by De Gael. He was trying to use that much vaunted mobility, and he clipped Smith with a left hand as he came in close.
De Gael just had a little look at the corner then, and one just straight a bit low.
They said that speed was going to be the key of this one, the De Gael camp. And hard though Smith may be, and they recognise that, that the speed, class and timing of De Gael would be the difference between these two. Smith's caught De Gael under the left eye. There's a little bit of swelling on the cheekbone there. High cheekbones anyway, lean sort of features. But Smith's found the target a couple of times. And the action hotting up in the closing seconds of the second.
But De Gael just got that extra class, hasn't he? Three shots and then turned Smith so well.
Interesting fight. And again, a big smile.
That's a beautiful, yeah. Hey, just put your shield, Well, listen, nice and calm. Well, James, left hand nice enough. Let's have a tight defence this round. Boxing knife, but just keep it a little bit tighter, yeah? Something nice. Keep putting around in the bag with a jab.
Come on, James.
Good boy. That's another one. Chang, you're too fast. You don't know what to do. You're not confused. You ain't got a pig in front of you. Leave it. Can it work with a jab? Jab, up that same hand, but backhand tight.
Some classy switched work on. From James De Gael. Pleasing Jim McDonnell, his chief trainer. And the speed may be something of the key, Glenn.
Yeah, some good work. Just asking for De Gael to keep his defences high in this round. Just wants him to tuck up. Don't give Smith any chances. They're just showing a bit of class.
Smith can be a slow starter in fights. We've seen that before. De Gael, well, for my money, probably edging the first two. But Smith is strong, rugged, committed. And he's got this passionate support. And if he enjoys even a measure of success, you will hear them start to roar him on. So slappy look to that left hand from De Gael. That's better though, the straight left was a solid punch.
Smith doesn't look fazed by it. Keeps his concentration, goes back to work.
He's not worried by De Gael's power, is he? I don't think he's been struggling with that thus far.
No, but I think the speed combined with power is what can give Smith problems. He's still very focused, knows what he's got to do, taking the fight to De Gael.
At the weigh-in, De Gael looked right in Paul Smith's eyes and said, "You're going to sleep." For one moment, I thought he was going to kick off right there and then.
No good then, they don't get paid then.
Paul Smith taking this fight as a voluntary. I would assume probably getting the best payday of his career. And the referee saying to De Gea, let's have some proper punches, not flicking. It's a good right hand from Smith.
Yeah, he's trying to get close to Smith. He's trying to land with some heavier punches. Just pushing De Gea back more in this round.
He's having a better round, isn't he? David Hay watching in the United States won't want to be reminded particularly of that fight against Carl Thompson, but in some ways it was the making of him. And there is just a little bit of a feeling among some people that maybe De Gea has taken this too soon and perhaps it could be a similar outcome. That's another good solid right hand from Smith and the crowd responds.
Just missing with a few punches in this round. De Gea, Smith, done all right.
He's having a better round, Glenn.
Yeah, he is. He's forced forward. He's landed with some meatier punches. Just made De Gea think a little bit.
De Gea looking to utilise that southpaw jab, that reach advantage. Smith keeping a nice tight guard.
Has looked for the punches in this round, but hasn't found them.
Doesn't quite look like a 6-1 on shot, has he?
No, not at this stage.
Last few seconds of a much better round for Paul Smith. Frank Warren, the promoter of both these fighters, and before the fight he said in a way he wasn't looking forward to it because he has affections and commitment of course for both men.
Corners,
he would in a way not like to see either of them beaten because Paul Smith, you can see, generates enormous enthusiasm from his Liverpool public. And James De Gea, well, has made a big investment on a talent that's emerging and looking to perform on the biggest stage.
You've got to admire him for making this fight, haven't you?
Absolutely.
You know, he wants to put good fights on, and this has turned out to be one.
Smith risking his number 4 WBO world ranking here. James De Gea, fresher, but lacking experience. And it's shaping up to be a fascinating fight.
Smith just having trouble at long range there. De Gea peppering him with that southpaw jab in the long left.
Those wins against Tony Quigley and Tony Dodson were tough fights, weren't they? And a bit of a question about how much that might have taken out of Smith.
Well, he also proved his mettle for a fight, and that he can handle fights like that.
Second time De Gea's been warned for holding. Howard Foster might be reaching the point where his patience is starting to be tested, and there again, he's dragging Smith on, and words of admonishment from the referee. De Gea's in slightly dangerous territory.
Nice left hook from Smith, and then the right hand.
This is where Smith's good. If he can turn it into more of a brawl, then clearly it's going to be in his favour. De Gea again being told that he was punching incorrectly. Head's coming in close.
Good punches inside from De Gea. That was a nice little flurry, rocking the head about of Paul Smith.
Big learning contest this one for De Gea. Look, Smith's cut around the right eye. It's around the edge of the eyebrow and the blood is starting to flow. Feared that was going to be a factor. I think it was a head clash that caused it. And now the corner man skills of Mick Williamson, who looked after Ricky Hatton for so many years, are going to be called into play. De Gea will get that psychological advantage, but Smith won't panic. He's been cut before and he's won before with cuts.
Yeah, but he's landed once or twice with good right hands. De Gea a little bit over for that with those low held hands. He needs to concentrate on defence a bit, De Gea.
A little bit contemptuous and taking a bit of a risk if he's hanging his chin out with fast hands from De Gea. Flurry of punches, and there's a bit of the braggart about him in there now. He's starting to really fancy his chances, and he's targeting that damaged right eye of Smith's.
Now showing the speed and combinations and good work from James De Gea.
Good round for De Gea. And now they have to go to work on Paul Smith and try and repair the damage. Blind side as we look at it, didn't get to see just how bad that is, but I suspect that the blood wasn't actually running into his eye, it was coming more down the side.
It didn't look too bad, certainly not for somebody like Mick Williams.
Here's how it happened. Clash of heads, we reckon. Let's watch in slow motion.
Yeah.
Oh, dear me.
Often happens when the Southpaw and the Orthodox fight. You know, they've got their leading hand, their leading legs and arms together. So they clash, and often you get cut eyes.
Corners, 10
but
seconds.
Gale also did some very good work, some nice combinations, and your sense just rattled Smith a little bit once or twice.
Round five.
James De Gale's never been past five rounds, which is the distance Sam Horton extended him at Upton Park on the Kevin Mitchell Katsidis undercard back in May. And now we move into the fifth round. Done a good job with that damaged eye of Smith's for the time being. De Gale's starting to unload with heavier shots. It was a good round for De Gea, the last one. Now Smith trying to redress the balance.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to throw his own combination, Smith. He needs to push De Gea against the ropes and work his combinations.
A lot made of the amateur record of James De Gea. Smith as well was a talented amateur. Silver medal in the Commonwealth Games in Manchester in 2002 when he was beaten by Jean Pascal, then an ABA title as well, but now the blood starts to flow again. And that right-hand jab, that right lead of De Gea is right on target. He's trying to pepper the injury, trying to worsen it.
Good shot left, yeah. Nice shot from De Gea. Fast reflexes. With one shot and left hook from Smith as the cut just weeps a little more blood.
It's always likely to be cuts as a factor in this. Can Smith, as we're in the fifth round, he see it through, or will it worsen? De Gea again spears him with that right jab. Smith so rugged, strong, hard and proud. De Gea, will he have the extra edge in class? At this stage, maybe it just suggests that he has. Smith's having his moments, but the better work is now coming from De Gea. Smith trying to fight back off those ropes, but shipped a decent right hand. Crowd trying to roar Smith on, trying to inspire him to move to greater heights. You hear the chants start to go up for this proud scouser, one of their own.
He's going to have to show that toughness and that pride.
Heads again clashed, and again, and that's definitely De Gea, and he really has to be stopped from doing that by the referee. He went in willfully with the head right into the face of Smith.
Low air of confidence about De Gea,
but he will be moving into uncharted territory in the next round. And Smith has said all along, the further this fight goes, the more it will suit me. Time's going to tell.
We've got to make him fight.
right. You've got to get in there, push the ball, stand on that. Get at me. You've got to get in there, you've got to make him fight.
Short,
yeah, all right.
You miss your walk, though.
Yeah, go ahead. Get at me now, come on.
Come on, breathe, come on.
Yeah, just walk, put it down the short one.
Aye.
You've got to break, man. You've got to get in and make him. Draw him into a fight. Push him down. Get up his right side. You step to your left. Move to your right. Move to your left. Up the side. Move to the left.
You've got to put the pressure on from this round, Paul. Sit down, what you've been working on.
Down, whack in the belly. Uppercuts and round the sides. Today,
the instructions of the Paul Smith corner are quite emphatic from the Paul father and son combination, George and Danny. Make it into a fight.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Yep, the right instructions. He's having some success doing that.
Round six.
Sixth round, and you sense that Smith needs a big one to get himself back into this fight. De Gale is edging it, edging the rounds. Quality work. And that's a lovely, lovely jab from De Gale. Think how indifferent he looked on his professional debut. He's grown in confidence under the tutelage of Jim McDonnell, who says that the problem is with him to keep him out of the gym rather than to get him in there. Smith's coming forward.
Working well with the free hand when he had his free Smith. This is what he's got to do, caught on the way in though.
He's caught by a right hook. And now De Gale has his gloves low and says to him, come on then, let's have some more of it. If you want it, here I am. Smith said that he would be the bully, he would be the stronger and the heavier puncher. Not so far.
Covering up well there, though, De Gale, showing he can use his defence when he needs to.
Heavy shots from both men being landed in close.
Good punch picking inside from De Gale, though. The body punching was lovely, and then nice left too. This is good from De Gale.
Switched up to the head as the blood starts to flow again from that right eye of Paul Smith, the champion, remember, in his second defence of his title. Trying to carry the fight to De Gale, being willed on by this huge crowd. Smith's been told he's got to get inside, got to work in close, land big hurtful hooks of his own. Smigger, smigger, chant of the faithful. De Gale's being patient, waiting for his opportunity. Big hook to the body from De Gale. Smith came in close. Been impressed with his close work tonight, De Gale.
Yeah, he's certainly learning quickly, isn't he? Good work, picks his punch as well. Even if he looks to be under pressure, he's got the coolness of head just to get the defence up and pick good body punches.
That's a good shot again from De Gale. Good left hook. And Smith forced to give ground as the left hand from De Gale went low. Smith being given time to recover. And the referee is saying to De Gale in no uncertain terms, I will not stand for it. Keep them up.
Has to be careful, De Gale.
He's been told off for dragging his man onto punches, and now he's been told for low punches. And Smith, as is his right, is taking plenty of time. We get the thoughts of Jamie Moore and Nicky Piper at the end of this round. Smith needs something big to impose himself on De Gale. Last few seconds of the sixth round. De Gale wants to get up on his bike. Good solid right hand. Let's join Ed Robinson.
Well, Nicky, it's getting very interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, Paul Smith is starting to put him through the test that we thought he would put him through. De Gale is having to fight harder than he's ever fought before. But he's starting to land some clean shots now. Smith's having successes too. I think it's going the way I thought it would go, but, you know, it's really looking tough. It's a hard fight, this one.
Jamie Moore, is the cut a worry for Paul Smith?
I don't think so. He's been through these things before, you know, in 12-round fights. I think this is the point in the fight now where De Gale's going to have to start, you know, he's going to start realising he's in a hard, tough fight, so we'll see what he's made of now.
How do you see it going from here?
I stick with my prediction. I think Paul Smith's going to take over from here if, as I suspect, De Gea will start slowing down.
What about you, Nicky?
I'm still with De Gea, but I'm not confident.
Thanks, guys.
Well, he was a 6-1 on shot before it began, and he did quality work in that round, Glenn, but Smith said the further it goes, the more it would be into his hands.
Well, those that said this is going to be a hard fight for an eighth fight. Novice in the pro terms going into a British title fight against a seasoned pro. It was always going to be a little bit difficult, but to be honest, for me, he's handling this very well indeed and showed some great qualities.
Smith's stamina has been proven. He's gone the 12 round distance. James De Gea, well, he's young, he's fit, he's clearly in great shape as he lands a really good quality right hand and gets far the better of that exchange. He's 10-1 on now with the bookies. There's how Glenn scores it. De Gea, overwhelming favourite with the bookies right now. But Smith is still there, and while he's there, it's dangerous.
It is dangerous, but you're just seeing a little gulf, a little difference in class, you know. For somebody with so little experience to do this, you know, it really is something.
Oh, lovely stuff from De Gea. Good variety of punches.
We're all getting through, John. Such a class.
De Gea showing himself to be a quality operator. If we didn't know it already, we know it now. But other qualities might yet be tested. Resilience, ability to take a punch. Smith just starting to get into closer range. Oh, he took a good right hand as he came in there, walked straight onto it.
Well, both these guys are nice guys outside the ring, friendly kids, and you know, but they're really showing the mettle here, showing what this game's all about, showing what a British title means.
Something really good about seeing a British title fight generate this sort of interest. That's a big attack from De Gea.
I think a lot of it is just to see, you know, what are we watching? What is this Olympic champion going to do? Is he going to be the next star? So far, he's looking on his way to be that, because this is mightily impressive for me.
I remember being there a few years ago, Glenn, when Gary Mason, who was a British champion, went in against Lennox Lewis. And those who thought that Gary Mason would have a little bit too much for Lewis, didn't quite turn out that way, and look what followed.
Smith. Game as ever. This is Liverpool fans proud. Fights back, shows that grit, that determination. He was always going to do that.
In the seventh round, last few seconds. Gale's done all that's been asked of him so far. That's him on his foot on the floor, but it's no knockdown. And the referee says as much, the crowd responded. And there's the bell to end another round, probably for James De Gea.
You're not waiting.
You've got to start waiting.
He's necking the rounds off you all the time here. You've got to start getting it going. You've got to get in there and you've got to work him hard, you know.
Listen, you've got to start working this fucking body out. And when you need to start stepping it up now,
Walter.
When you need to step it up, kid, you've got to push him back and let the shots go poor. Let's get this completely from you, kid. Let's get away from you, lads. You need to start stepping up. Come on, Paul Smith.
He said Paul Smith is brave and that he's strong and he'll try and respond to the support of the crowd, but he was just starting to get hurt a little bit maybe in that last round, Glenn.
Yeah, just starting to unravel slightly with good punches coming in from De Gea. It puts them together and clusters, you know, it's hard to defend against punches like that.
Eighth round, British super middleweight title on the line, and James De Gea has to have a cushion of points now as we move round to the latter stages of what's been a fascinating fight, and James De Gea has passed the test so far. Smith corner, what would you have been telling him, Glenn? How can he possibly impose himself on De Gale, who's really done all that's required so far.
It's going to take grit and determination. The moment De Gale hasn't been anywhere like this before, it could all start falling apart for him if Smith starts landing some meaningful punches. So he's got to keep going.
Got to get him into the trenches.
Yep, got to make him fight. Should take him somewhere he's never been before. He can still do that. There's still plenty of time in the fight.
If Smith comes through this, of course, he'll hope for big money fights in the future. And he's got a mountain to climb right now. The girl has him in that corner again. And he's shipping more punishment. Solid shots going in from the Olympic champion. Great right hand.
Very impressive, isn't it? You know, it's good to see somebody put combinations together like this. You know, you don't often see it against such a good fight like Paul Smith, but really showing a measure of class.
Only in his ninth professional fight, remember. Smith inside, landing a good solid hook of his own. Examples of inexperienced fighters who've upset the odds. Leon Spinks and Muhammad Ali, most famously perhaps of all. That's good again. Oh, great uppercut! And that right uppercut was a tremendous shot. Really rocked back Smith's head, and I thought for one moment he was going to go, and it certainly wobbled him.
Dazzling combination. Excellent work from De Gale, time and time again.
Well, that right uppercut of De Gale's was the punch of the fight for me. Smith took it though and came back and threw some hurtful shots of his own.
But that's what he does so good, puts it together in combinations, and that's what other fighters have got to learn from. You know, it's easy to defend against one punch or two, but when you've got three, four, five, six coming at you in body and head, that's hard. You can't protect yourself against that.
Having thrown that dazzling combination, maybe De Gale just wanted to take a little bit of a breather, or perhaps it was that he didn't want to take any undue and unnecessary risks. Whatever, he's allowed Smith to regroup, and he'll see it through safely to the bell to end the round. So it would seem. Again, De Gale told off. That's for the third time for dragging his man in with around the back of the head. Well, here was De Gale's attack, and there's that right uppercut. Great shot, Glenn.
Yep, excellent combination. There it is. Just didn't quite get under the chin, or could have done more damage.
It's as well for Smith, it didn't.
I'm sure it is. Painful enough, though.
Another big round for James De Gale. Smith is a long way behind on the cards, and he has got to have a big round soon if he's going to turn this one around. De Gale has thrown twice as many, he's landed twice as many, success rate much the same, but De Gale has just thrown too many punches for Paul Smith, and this proud champion needs something special in the last four rounds if he's going to turn it around.
Straight out, straight action, straight punches. The southpaw jab and left.
Remember in Sheffield when Joe Calzaghe beat Chris Eubank. A new star was born on that night. Smith has not had the achievements in the ring of a Chris Eubank, but he's a tough, hard man. And are we seeing another star emerging here in James De Gale? Better from Smith, trying to bully De Gale around.
Smith's shown his grit and determination.
Doesn't quite have the hand speed though, does he, Glenn? Not quite got the technique. Right the way through, you feel that the added edge in class has laid with James De Gale.
Big left hook and a right hand.
Oh, he's in trouble now, Smith. He was caught flush by that left hook. Now he wants to cover up and just buy a few seconds. Could end right here and now. Huge right hook as well from De Gale, but Smith holds on and rides out the storm. Can De Gale take him here in this ninth round? Smith bravely tries to fight back off the ropes. Fighting instinct and fighting heart from the Scouts hero. De Gale must have thought that he had him there.
Well, what motivates these men? Paul Smith, having taken those huge shots right back in the face of James De Gale now, trying to carry the fight back to the young pretender.
But Paul Smith will lose nothing in a defeat here, because we're seeing how courageous he is, how much grit, determination, and we're seeing that he's in with a pretty special talent who's going to go on to great things. Hurt again with a left hook there, Smith. And the referee's got to be keeping an eye on
him. Oh, terrific left hand, and that's the end of it. Smith's been rescued in the ninth round. Left hand from James De Gale brought the end, and Howard Foster, who'd been looking at it very closely, he stepped in. A few boos from the crowd. That's not really deserved, because James De Gale, for me, proved tonight that he is very much the genuine article. If we didn't know before, we know now. His lad can fight, he has class. He went in against a hard man, and he's taken him out.
On that sort of performance, so early in his career, James De Gale could go on to be a big star, really could. I think this is the emergence in what should have been a tough fight. He dominated, beautiful combinations, and finished it in superb style. And gritty as ever, looking to come forward, Paul Smith just walks onto a left hook, and he can do that. He can hit and hurt, even with his back up against the ropes. Got so much ability, so much speed, and definitely got the power. Good concentration, always looking for the gaps, but look how he reacts, look how the quick punches come out, combinations.
And when the end came, it was a good stoppage from Howard Foster. The crowd didn't like it, but he was spot on.
Yeah, he had to be watching at this point, and he was. And De Gale was just going to throw him more punches. What a good fight.
He didn't like it, he was a brave man. De Gale was quality. Took a lot of big shots. The accuracy of De Gale is what was so impressive. Well, Paul Smith would have kept on fighting until he dropped. James De Gale had his moment of celebration. He loved it. The crowd inevitably bitterly disappointed, some of them already leaving the arena. But James De Gale, unquestionably a big man and a big star for the future. Bitter disappointment for Smith. He thought that he had his number. And nice to see De Gale going across and consoling him. Smith bitterly, bitterly disappointed. But here is Mark Burdis giving confirmation of a result, which means there is